Hi, in this video, we're going to talk about the importance of building a team. My name is Adam Adams. I'm the host of the Creative Real Estate Podcast. And recently, I interviewed a man by the name of Trevor McGregor. They call him Coach Trevor. Coach Trevor talks about two things that are important when you're trying to be successful. And they both start with M. It's mindset and modeling, okay? We're going to talk about the modeling. We're talking about looking at teams that are doing this and implementing everything that they're doing. So what's important to note on this is that you need to be doing what the top 1% are doing. If you want 1% goals, you can't do what the 99% are doing. So there's five ways that you can model a successful company that's actually doing syndications, a lot of them. And there's five things that I want to talk about for modeling, okay? So we look at all of the companies that are actually doing big, big things, and they all have these five in common. They're executing well on all of these. And it doesn't mean you need five people. Maybe you need one person. Maybe you need 100 people, but there's five main categories, and those are direction, deals, money, management or admin, and legal. Let's get started with direction, all right? So you might need a few people or one person that is really driving the bus, okay? So you need like a visionary, somebody who's able to see where the company can go. And another part of that is you need market research. So if you're going to find a real good direction of where your company is going to go, you need to understand the markets in the world that'll bring you there, that'll give you the best returns for your goals, okay? So a great market research team is somebody who's going to be detailed, detail-oriented. They might be able to fly out and talk to the Chamber of Commerce. So they'll have some skills like people person, you know, and they'll be more analytical. So this is kind of somebody who is very much in the middle of focusing really much on the details and focusing very much on getting along with other people, okay? Then you are looking at the deals. So to get deals, you can't do deals without deals to do. So we are talking about acquisitions person, somebody to do the underwriting. Those are very, very important, and they can be the same person, but they might be different. And here's why. If you are talking about the acquisition specialist, the person on your team that is bringing the deals to you, a lot of times they're going to be really good networkers. They're going to be out there shaking hands, remembering people, being very, very personable, and maybe even omnipresent. So maybe they're all over Facebook, all over LinkedIn, all over social media, and people are finding them and saying, these guys got the deals. So when I have a deal, I'm going to bring it to the person who's omnipresent, the person that I get along with because they're personable, the person that I have networked with, shaken hands with because they've been at the same meeting that I have. Okay. So you also need to make sure you're credible. If you're going to be omnipresent, be very, very credible. And then this person needs to be able to do what's called pre-underwriting. So it's very easy to do pre-underwriting, but they need to be able to do a quick analysis if that deal works for us or not, or works for you or not. Okay. With that said, that you might have a full-time underwriter or a whole underwriting staff who the acquisitions people are, they're the people person, and then maybe this underwriting person is an engineer, maybe they love numbers, they're very detail-oriented, they can make decisions without their emotions, so they might be able to say, hey, we need to walk away from this, even if originally somebody else would have been like, oh, we need that deal, we'll just make it work. You know, your underwriter needs to be very, very cautious, careful, numbers oriented, numbers driven, and not worrying about the emotions on buying a property, because these are not single family houses. This isn't where you're going to live. You need to be focused more on the numbers. Okay. So we talked about direction. We talked about deals, money, equity partners. So you need to decide, are you doing a 506B, which is friends and family only, or are you doing a 506C? Now, the reason I say that is, in 506C is accredited investors only, and you may advertise, okay, generally solicit your deals. So you've got to decide, what are you doing? And now you have to figure out, you know, if it's a 506B, maybe you have a really good networker, a person on the team who's really good at going out and meeting these investors that can become your friends and family, okay? Become your friends. Your close acquaintances, people that you know, like, and trust, you have built a substantial relationship with, or are you doing 506C? If you're doing 506C, now you're going back into that need to be omnipresent. You need to be putting out content, sharing information with other people. My team, we do both. We have raised money from our friends, and we also do 506C general solicit offerings. And when we do that, we can only bring in accredited investors. So if you're accredited, talk to us. Or if you are like me and you're looking for accredited investors, doing content like this is very, very good. So a networker, you need credibility, probably education, a YouTube channel, podcast, etc. If you're going to be bringing in money, you need to be able to attract money. Okay. Very, very important. With that said, it's not just the equity partners. It's also the banks. So you're going to need experience, good credit score, and liquidity or net worth. Okay. So what that means is when you're talking about if you're going to qualify for a loan with a bank, there is three things that they're looking for. They need experience. They need, because that makes their money safe. Like a track record. You've managed a lot of properties before. You know the area. Okay. You also need to have liquidity. So the bank's not going to be safe lending you money unless you have money in the bank. Okay. So somebody has to have liquidity. You can partner with this liquidity. Like I said, in all five of these things, you might be able to have 100 people, or maybe it's just one person. It's your choice, but these are all the important things you need to focus on. So credit score is also very important. If you're qualifying for a bank, you can't have a 400 credit score, and, or else they won't even look at you. So you kind of have to focus on being able to be attractive to banks by either partnering with a good credit score, partnering with somebody with a net worth, and partnering with somebody with a track record. Or if you're already that person, that's fine. You don't need to go and search these people. The next one is number four, is administrative or management. And there's a lot of parts to this. Okay. And maybe it's the same person in your group. Maybe it's 100 people in your group. You got to have an investor relations person, somebody who makes sure that they're organized, they're patient, they're polite, they're honest, and they can communicate and talk with the investors for your group. You need to have an admin, the glue to the company, somebody who's organized, who listens well and follows direction, implements things quickly, okay? So the admin is going to be able to go through papers, be able to listen, take directions, and somebody needs to be able to do the administrative stuff. You will have also asset management, property management, and financial management, okay? Asset management, property management, financial and management. The asset management is the direction for the property, and you're basically managing the manager. You're going to have the property manager that could be in your team. You could might be able to hire that out. And by the way, both of those should be very experienced with that. So if it's not you, if you're not already experienced, partner with the right person. And then financial management, good financial reports, focusing on strong community with the residents. Hopefully, maybe that is your property management company that is making events for your tenants, for the residents that are living in that area. And the property manager is focusing on making sure that those guys get along. Every one of the residents is friends with each other. They get along with each other. They're helping each other out. They're watching each other's back. That community, when you're building a strong community, then you're going to have those residents stay for a very, very long time. So then we have legal. Legal is extremely important. You need somebody on your team or hire it out that is really good with contracts. So this might be an attorney, it might be an advisor, it might be an in-house person that is really, really good at reading, negotiating, and understanding these contracts. Then compliance. Again, attorneys, CPAs, making sure that you're taking in 401k money, IRA money appropriately, correctly, legally, you're reporting appropriately, legally, and you're in compliance with the law. So you're going to have attorneys, CPAs, and then finally, your entity structure. Okay, so this is very important. You will have probably another attorney who is structuring the entity for you. Okay, this is somebody creating the LLC or the LP. For instance, just a small thing on that is that if you're taking in Canadian money, you can't have an LLC. It has to be a limited partnership. And literally, the entity has to be an LP to legally do that. So you have to have the entity structure correct. So you, again, more attorneys. All right. So the legal is very, very important. So to wrap it up, you need five things: direction, deals, money, management, and legal. The most important thing to note here is that you should double down on your strengths and surround yourself with your weaknesses when partnering and building your team. Okay. So take some time and reflect yourself to figure out exactly what is it that you're truly good at? What is it that you really bring to the table, and find a way to double down on that and let other people work with you and leverage their time. Okay. The rich, the 1%, they're leveraging other people's time. And it could be any one of these things. You might be able to do it yourself or have a team of 100. But whatever you do, I want you to go forth and I want you to own tons and tons of real estate because you love it and you're passionate about it. And don't ever say, I can't. Always figure out who you need to partner up with to figure out how can I. Good luck. Until next time, think outside the box.